One of the difficult things about working from archival photographs is there's no scale to the photographs. And to determine how much to chop out of the roof, we had to find a common object to the real car and to the model, which turned out to be the upper door hinge. So if we measure the upper door hinge on the photograph and then multiply it out, the window opening on the real car is about 4 1/3 door hinge units. So then measure the hinge on the model, multiply that out to about 4 1/3, and that'll give you the distance of the window opening after the top was chopped. It turned out to be just about 3 millimeters, so that's how I determined how much to take out of the roof. Here I've laid out some Tamiya fine line masking tape around the upper body and to serve as a cut line for when I chop the top. And then some careful work with a razor saw and trying to keep the cut straight and parallel resulted in removing the required 3 millimeters out of the model kit's roof. Here I've used a piece of brass wire pressed into the door gap channel on the B-pillar to serve as an alignment guide. And it shows that the two halves don't line up too badly. The biggest part will be the rear blend around the rear window. But the rear window opening has some really nasty parting seams from the original molds, so I'll have to rework that anyway. Here's how it looks after the first session of filler and bodywork and a guide coat of primer shot over it. It's really essential to use primer and a guide coat to reveal the flaws that are in your bodywork. Because on raw plastic it may look beautiful, but you get that over it and start sanding it a little bit and all of your flaws will pop and tell you where you need to do some rework. You can see there's some edges near the window opening where the body was cut, and then here on the side quarter windows where there's some work that still needs to be done. The front windshield opening on this is going to be difficult as well because it's a insert and it's very delicate, and you got to maintain those gaps and openings properly. But this is just the first session with the filler and some preliminary work, and it'll get cleaned up a lot better before it goes to paint. Here's a very useful little tip or trick. Use some brass pins or wire and drill some holes in your parts and use the pins to align them. That way you can take things apart repeatedly and it'll go back together again in exactly the same place every time. I had these fenders on and off a dozen times at least, determining how to cut them and how to bob them down. And now with the pins, I can actually take them on and off the car and they go back in exactly the same place every time. And then also, I drilled a second set of holes in the two fenders so I could put them together side by side as mirror images and transfer my layout lines and cut lines to both fenders and make sure that they do look like mirror images of each other. And it really helps. And then when you're done, you can fit them back on the car, take a look, take them off, and they go back in exactly the same place. Here's some shots with some rough cuts done to the fenders, front edges, rear edges, working my way up to my pencil lines, and then back on the car to take a look for comparison, and then looking at some archival pictures again to make sure I get the angles right. I think this turned out really well, but you can use this pins trick on just about any part that you need to remove and get back on multiple times. And I also shaved down the edges of the plastic fenders to make them much thinner to look like actual rolled sheet metal instead of being a scale 2 inches thick. After I was happy with the final bodywork, I masked off the fabric roof panel using bare metal foil for the precision edge and then regular masking tape to protect the rest from overspray. Then I shot it with Model Master flat black. After the roof panel had dried several days, it was remasked the other way using bare metal foil and regular masking tape. And then the rest of the parts were prepped and readied and then shot with the Boyd's yellow Model Master paint. So this is about it for this installment, and final assembly will be the next one. Thanks for watching. I hope some of my tips and tricks will help you in your future modeling projects, and we'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.